Monsieur le commissaire,
Mr.
est-ce
Commissioner,
que les
should
citoyens
European
européens
citizens be
doivent
seriously
commencer
worried
à
about their
avoir
savings?
sérieusement peur pour leurs épargnes?
Franchement, je ne le crois pas.
Frankly, I don't
Semaine
think
après
so.
Semaine,
Week after week,
nous mettons
we've
en place
put in
des
place
régulations.
Regulations.
Nous obligeons
we
à la
require
transparency. Nous allons
and we'll
exiger
hold
la
to account all the financial players in all the markets and all the products they use.
Pour tous les produits
we're
utilisent.
In the process of drawing up proposed legislation aimed at protecting savers' deposits and those of investors.
Et justement, quelle
exactly
être
what
la
level of protection can European investors expect?
Les épargnants européens.
Et le texte est extrêmement clair. Nous avons exigé.
The wording is very clear. We're proposing to pass legislation guaranteeing European savers up to the level of 100,000 euros. If I may, I want to go beyond the protection of consumers.
Si vous me le permettez,
what's important is that employment grows. It's the competitiveness of Europe that matters. And for this, we must draw lessons from the crisis that destroyed economic growth, which in turn destroyed competitiveness. This crisis has cost us 10% of GDP in Europe because it took that to save the banking system, which is directly related to the savings of the citizens.
Parce qu'il a fallu sauver le système bancaire qui est justement lié à l'épargne des citoyens.
On doit aussi franchir une étape importante.
It should be an important step making banks more responsible for guaranteeing their capitalization.
En ce qui concerne leur capitalisation.
Nous allons effectivement mettre
we'll
en
effectively implement the European laws if Parliament and the ministers adopt the recommendations of Basel III to increase capital and funds of the European banks. Then those banks, all 8,230 of them, will be the first to do so in the world. And we hope that other continents, including the United States, will follow suit.
Est-ce que les stress tests
have the recent stress tests for banks demonstrated a need for such measures?
Les stress tests sont des
tests
de résistance.
The stress tests are tests of resistance to events that never actually happened.
They're
useful and we're improving them every year. This year they were more rigorous, transparent and credible.
Est crédible.
But it didn't take into account the CDS, the insurance on defaults.
C'est vrai qu'il y a
it's true that there are tests that have only been applied to certain parts of their business. But in terms of risks on sovereign debt, it's easy to calculate who's dependent on who, who's exposed to what.
Qui est exposé à quoi.
Est-ce qu'il y a un risque dans le système
is there a risk that if a country defaults, then that will result in banks falling into default as well?
Les banques aussi. Entre en défaut.
Nous avons participé au sauvetage de trois pays.
We participated in the rescue of three countries, Greece, Ireland and Portugal. We've put in place emergency government measures, a solidarity fund. We've also put in place measures to ensure that it doesn't happen again.
Qu'est-ce qui ne doit pas recommencer? C'est l'endettement.
Mais toutes ces dettes-là doivent disparaître.
All such debts should disappear, but they're held by certain banks and the banks are exposed to speculation. So what's the solution?
Nous avons demandé,
we've asked, and it's also a debate that took place in the European Council, that the private sector participates in the recovery of countries such as Greece, and it maintains its level of exposure. It's not a question of accepting default so much as offering support.
But the European Central Bank is against that?
Against what?
The
participation of the private sector. It's a discussion that's taking place. It's a question of participating and maintaining a level of exposure. It's not to accept any default. The whole plan of support and solidarity has been set up precisely to ensure that there's no default by an individual state or a bank.
But
the ratings agencies are saying that any agreement with the banks for their participation in the rescue of Greece will be considered as a kind of default of payment.
De la Grèce, on va considérer ça comme une sorte de défaut de paiement.
Nous n'avons pas cette appréciation.
We don't look at it like that.
Enfin,
the discussion is currently taking place. We do everything to avoid default, and it's precisely that philosophy and purpose of support that's been brought to Greece. Although I think that it is logical and legitimate that the private sector take part in this collective effort. Moreover, it's in their interest. As far as the rating agencies are concerned, I have to say that I found it surprising to see the ratings fall over the past few months without any warning to these countries, while those countries are engaged in a very important collective effort.
Alors que ces pays sont engagés dans un effort collectif très important.
Les déclassements des
the downgrading of sovereign debt of some European countries has been made by ratings agencies that are not even in Europe. Shouldn't we give more responsibility to the EU?
Ça ne devrait pas donner plus de responsabilité.
Shouldn't we have a European ratings agency controlled by European institutions?
Contrôlée par les institutions européennes.
Vous avez raison de dire qu'il y a trop peu.
You're right in that there are too few ratings agencies. Three major credit ratings agencies in the world is not enough, given the influence these agencies can have in all areas of finance. So the first thing to do is to increase competition. And so, one way or another, I hope we can encourage private initiatives to create new credit ratings agencies. But it's also important to reduce the influence of these ratings agencies, to reduce the dependence on these ratings. These ratings are used too much in drawing up regulations, all regulations, including the banks. What I'm proposing today is that the banks make their own judgments without relying on what these agencies say.
Dans les décisions des banques européennes. Enfin, c'est la proposition que nous faisons.
D'accord, merci.